It is called deer antler spray, or sometimes referred to deer antler velvet.
Deer antler spray. I have no idea.
It's to spray in the air so that deer antlers don't come near you.
Something for hunting?
According to Sports Illustrated, which broke this story, deer antler spray is a sports supplement that has been marketed to some of the nation's top athletes by a company called SWATS, or Sports with Alternatives to Steroids. Deer antlers go through a growth stage where they are covered in fuzz. That velvet naturally contains a hormone called IGF-1. It is an insulin-like protein that is used to promote growth. SWATS told Sports Illustrated that it can take the deer antler velvet, freeze-dry it, extract it, and turn it into a spray form or a pill. Owner Mitch Ross claims the products can help boost performance and help muscle recovery. Ross says they have a long list of well-known customers.
Big name players want to make perform at a higher level.
But IGF-1 is banned by the major pro leagues, the NCAA and the PGA Tour. After the story broke, pro golfer Vijay Singh acknowledged using the substance. But in a statement, he said, quote, "When I first received the product, I reviewed the list of ingredients and did not see any prohibited substances. I am absolutely shocked that deer antler spray may contain a banned substance and am angry that I have put myself in this position." SWATS also says Baltimore Ravens linebacker Ray Lewis has also used their product, a claim he strongly denied. In a statement, the company says, quote, "We have always been about aiding athletes to help heal faster and participate in an optimum level of play in a lawful and healthy manner. We never encourage the use of harmful supplements and or dangerous drugs." But even with all of the controversy, it's not even certain whether taking the deer antler velvet as a pill or spraying it in your mouth will have any effect whatsoever. Dr. Joshua Cohen of George Washington Medical Center explains why.
IGF-1 is a protein. It's a peptide. And in general terms, peptides need to be given typically as an injection. As you know, for example, insulin is a peptide, and people who take insulin give themselves an insulin injection.